Howdy, folks, and welcome back. Let's dig around in Dungeonmans. As per usual, we were just picking up where we left off, and we are going to continue the adventures of Devon. Now, one thing I'm going to do, partially to show it off, but I think it'll also kind of keep gameplay fresh between characters, is that between each character, I'm going to reset the overworld. So we're going to create an entirely new overworld here. You do this, he's like, are you sure? And I'm like, yes. The only thing we'll be missing out from this is that we won't be able to get bonuses from giving purloined inventory to towns, which I'm actually okay with. So now when we go outside, you will see that we have a new overworld. Fancy. But as per usual, the Ook Fells and the convenient Scrobbled Warrens are both right here, should we wish to do them. You'll see that they're trivial difficulty, so we can just stomp them. The exception is the Kobold War, the Scrobbled Warrens here, which regardless of the difficulty of it, you can actually come into. I don't know if it will eventually hit. Okay, so it will eventually hit mundane. I'm just gonna kind of chew through this really quick because there's not really gonna be anything that's a threat to us here. So, I mean, I guess we can pick up like healing potions and stuff. Go ahead and just kill everything. There. Okay, the boss should be down here somewhere. I can never remember if he's on the third or fourth level of this. This might not even have a fourth level. I'm just doofy enough that I can't remember. One more. Get all of you guys? I can. Wow, they survived. That's surprising. Well, I guess that's fair. This is adventurous. We are only fourth level. All right, let's get some fuego going here. Cook some scrobolds. There we go. All right, that's something following me. Get out of here. You're of no threat or concern to me, Scrobbold. Okay, I've actually noticed that the dev, when he plays, he actually just grinds overworld encounters for the first level. So he doesn't actually come to like the Scrobbled Warrens, and I don't recall, he might not even do the Ook Fells, which having watched him do it is probably a quicker way to get through the first couple levels, because you can actually level pretty quick doing overland stuff. Alright, there's a scroll back there. I suppose we can go back to that. What do we got? Bolster armor. I'm glad I did go back for it. Not super useful to us right now, but eventually. A bendy iron heater shield. Oh, you silly little mage, where are you going? I think the Deep Roll the Thunder's activated ability would be better if, in addition to doing damage, it maybe stunned things for a round, just to give you like enough time to close with ranged users. Although I guess as a psychomancer, you have your jump and stuff. You're not completely helpless against range. It's just kind of a pain in the ass sometimes. Alright, so we're gonna jump off of this wall and dropkick this dude. Like that. Oh, there's another champion back there. Nice. We're gonna kill him. Get two proofs of strength. I'll take it. Not bad. One of these days, I might roll, maybe after this character, I don't know. It depends on whether or not I remember. I might roll a character with the trait that makes it so that there are more champions in the world. It's actually pretty a pretty good way to get a bunch of proofs of strength for your current character as well as future graduates. Hey there, buddy. We got things! Yay! Proofs of strength. Alchemy lab. No books. Identify my stuff. We got some clunky blandals! Thankfully, I'm not using those. Guess we'll just go straight on into strength. We're gonna be shoring up our strength pretty high on this character. It's gonna be overworld. Let's see. I don't think we got anything too interesting in there, but we might have. No. Magi thread bracers, which are spell power, which is, I think, pretty well useless for what we're doing here. Let's see, our poncho's better. We got the super pants. So yeah, I'd say we're good. See, I'm not even gonna, well, here, we can break this, get some trash loot. If nothing else, it gives us stuff to psycho toss at things. And a scroll of bees, please. A scroll. Take it. Okay, let's see what we have over here. We're in adventurous territory now. We've got Ah, trivial. Damn it. I was hoping this would be mundane. Whatever. Here we go. The Fortress of Forsaken Secrets. Bloodied corpses ring the entrance. A nightmare that no one remembers. Would evil choke this place into silence? I don't know. But there's gonna be some noise while I'm moving through it. Probably in the vein of screeching as I'm, you know, turning people into human pretzels and whatnot. Alright, so we have a champion here, so I'm gonna step here. I'm gonna activate Rip Your Wit. Oh, it missed me. That's great. I'm gonna punch it in the mouth and then counterattack it to death. Okay. But as you can see, I mean, our damage is pretty good. You'll kind of be a little lacking in late game, but by then you typically have other things to rely on. Like, I found that as you progress with a Psychomancer, a lot of it becomes you psycho-tossing things. Because it adds a pretty surprising amount to your damage output. Alright, here are the stairs down. Since it's mundane, we'll just head on straight down. And I'm sure some of you are probably wondering why I go for these ones that are mundane instead of just going for adventurous, even though when I enter the mundanes, I beeline for the stairway down. The reason behind that is I want to squeak the XP and stuff out of them while it's still viable to do so. Because, I mean, if it's mundane and I go for adventurous and gain a level, all the mundane stuff becomes trivial. So I think I can kind of work some extra XP out of it by going into stuff that's mundane. If I really wanted to level more quickly, I'd go into stuff that's dangerous. But as a melee class, that will get you dead fairly quickly if you aren't playing incredibly carefully, which, as you guys have seen, oh, these guys are just being jerks. And they're probably gonna have to eat some damage here, so we're just gonna come up here. There, just gonna let the fire die. Oh my god, you freaking grenadiers. Here, you wanna play with fire? Play with some fire. Jerk. Oh my god. Oh man, is he following me? Seriously, dude? Seriously? Oh yeah, where are you going now? That's right, run down the friggin' corner hallway. Obnoxious freaking bees. Alright. Ninja moves, how do you like that? The developer has talked about the possibility of eventually allowing the player to enchant their fists, which I think is really cool. Like, that's a good way to go about it. I mean, he could also, I suppose, go like the way of, God, what is it? Like DDO, where instead of, DDO is Dungeons and Dragons Online, for anyone who may not know. Where the monks there, instead of letting them enchant their fists, they actually give them hand wraps that they can wear that have, you know, various enchantments on them to make them more powerful. Ah! Everybody burns. Boot barter. Oh, there's a secret around here somewhere, huh? Let's do some wall bumping. In here? No. I don't know. The aha! Ah, freaking portal room. I'm not even gonna bother with it. Those rooms are just so obnoxious. Just drive me nuts. Okay, we are almost done with this level. Oh, another one. Oh, another one, huh? Can I just like, if I just sit here and wait? No. Nope. I hate everything. Trash tier treasure rooms, damn it. Oh, book. Armor's Almanac, is that real armor? If that's real armor, that is real armor. What is that going to net us? It's gonna get us our third tier ability, which we normally won't get for another two levels. Reduce all damage taken by 20%. In addition, we deal more damage with our next attack for each enemy that hits you in the preceding round. All right, we'll use that. Sure. That's pretty solid, you know? I'll work with that. Getting some goodies early as the upside to starting with scrolls. And that's another thing is like, you know, I've mentioned that depending on the books you get, you can kind of base your initial starting skills off of them. But if you don't mind holding on to them for a while, you can also do what I just did there. You know, if you hold on to them until third level, you can unlock abilities that you wouldn't otherwise be able to get until sixth. So, like, it's pretty good. And generally, I would say it's probably more worth waiting until third level holding on to them, because getting to third level doesn't take too long. And yeah, it's nice to be able to unlock a second tier ability, which you get at third level, but the time it takes to get from 1 to 3 is not too great. So by comparison to the time it takes to get... Alright, I'll show these things off. Alright, you got a pool. Pool in front of you swirls with water laced with a mysterious magic. Who knows how long it's been here? Dungeon sense, you can never be sure, but you have a good feeling about this pool. Let's drink from it. Our body flashes with energy and spirit, even gathering more of a dungeon man's true power and increasing my strength by 1. Nice, permanent stat upgrade. A good feeling, sure. Oh, Filthy mostly was waiting at the bottle. Waiting for friendship. Alright. Well, this one. Another one! Oh, I'm extremely fragile for 100 turns. That's okay. We have mostlies. It doesn't matter. I'm just gonna camp right here for 100 turns. I'm not worried about anything. Our mostlies will fight for me. Look at that. Look at them go. My ferocious undead compatriots. Alright. So apparently Dungeon Sense is good to have for that. I didn't know that it actually affected those, because I normally just completely avoid them. See, we detected something around here. Oh, it's a dungeon book merchant. Nice. What do you got? A bunch of books I can't use because they're thousands of gold, but maybe some useful scrolls. Bolster armor, combat blinking. I'm gonna buy both of those. We will buy pin to win. And that's it. Eat curse can be really, really useful. You can chew curses off of items that are on you, and there's actually another scroll you can get that curses your gear, and you can kind of use those hand in hand. And you can get like hit point bonuses and stuff from that. It can be really useful for kind of shoring up your stats. Alright, so we have an archer down there, which realistically I'm not worried about at all. Take pride in knowing you'll be amongst my greatest victories. You, on the other hand, are just another speed bump on the way to the level cap. Alright, these dudes, alright, as a champion, this guy can do a throwing starburst that does quite a bit of damage, and he's probably going to do it as he approaches me. And then they do a charge, which also does quite a bit of damage. How long does this last? 30% less physical damage. We'll pop that. 13 rounds, alright. So we have... Alright, we're gonna nail him with that. I think he's within range of this. Yep, there's the charge, which we actually got through without issue. I'm gonna weapon bend here, and we are going to rapier wit. And now we're just gonna melee him down. There we go. Not bad at all. He did. Seriously, bee. Freaking random bees. I got a Crushonium door spike. Oh, I'm coming for you. Where are you going now? That's right. The corner of shame. And death. Okay. Let's come here, turn our stuff in. I'm probably gonna be spending some points on skill, if I had to guess. This time. I don't think we have any extra books. No. So let's see how this goes. We only have 2. So yeah, I'm gonna... we only have enough for 1 point. As a small effect on maximum stamina, sure. Let's see if this actually bumps our stamina at all. Yeah, 2 points. All right. So we got 71 stamina. That's okay. Your ability's stamina cost, I believe, does scale up with you as you level to some extent. I don't know if it's percentile based or what. But it is always good to have more stamina, especially for like this character. Oh, hey, we got ambushed, because we are essentially purely stamina at this point. So rapier wit, I'm gonna maim one of you guys poorly, apparently. April the Thunder? Let's get away from that. There. there. Oh, he's gonna burn to death, I think. Yeah. Not too worried about that. All right, what else do we have floating around here? Okay. Some bees. Where you going, buddy? Ah, you foiled my plans. Move straight towards you. There we go. Oh, some slimes and snakes. Ooh, more bandits. Let's do this. I'll punch you all while I'm on fire. That's what this class needs. This class needs the ability to let them light themselves on fire and beat enemies to death. Just saying. It would bring this game to a whole nother tier of quality. So let's continue along, see if we can find anything. Dangerous, let's avoid that one. Actually, mostly curious in just going to this town. I don't think we have any purloined inventory. No, not looking like it. Nope, all right. Well, we have a shop wherein, let's see. Did I pick up anything worthwhile in that dungeon? I'm gonna go ahead and guess now, no. Yeah, hey there. Buy all of my items that aren't equipped or locked? No, I wanna sell some stuff, but not everything. I'm gonna sell my armor because I do not have the skill that lets me build towers out of this stuff yet, so it's just kind of taking up inventory space, and I'm not using it. So we're gonna just kind of trash it all. What is this ring? Range damage, hot garbage. We'll hold on to door spikes. I will hold on to a door spike because, realistically, I mean, I spiked a door on Devon the Second, and that's probably the first door spike I've used in a legitimate sense ever in this game. I don't really use them too often. It'll be better, I think, once we can throw them at doors that are further away. But as it is, like, having to be right next to the door makes kind of like fleeing from things impossible because they're gonna be on your ass anyways. Here. I'll pass on all of that. Potions of Barkskin are tempting, but. Healing stamina potions. Let's see, we only have 12 gold. I'm gonna pass on those too. Don't wanna spend all of my money on potions. Yet. If they were champion potions, I would. But they're not. Another ambush. Adventures. Oh man, this could be bad. I'll jump down here. I'm gonna activate my first defensive ability. It's mostly the archers that I'm worried about here. We're gonna psycho toss some stuff. Get some ranged combat going here. Actually, some AoE damage. Oh god, there's one of those DM pangolins back there. Haha, you fools, I leveled up. Now this is a fair fight. What skills do we have? We could get, keep the good, discard the bad, which I always forget I have when I get it. Psycho Soldier applies bleeds. And when opening containers, they will be flung at nearby targets. I think we're gonna go with this. Plus it's gonna upgrade our weapon damage. The main reason that I'm going for this is because this is going to make our weapon toss bleed things, and next level I'm going to be getting Redran the Rivers, which lets us do a really powerful attack on enemies that bleed. So, pretty good! Pretty dang good. That having been said, we have to survive this. That archer in the background is out of range, those bees are out of range. It's okay. We're gonna activate Defiant and just start punching things. That's what we do. Frickin' pangolins. Have some fire. That worked surprisingly well. I'm gonna need a weapon mend to catch these two because I know they're both just going to run from me anyways. There we go. All right. That honestly went really well. I'm pretty pleased, all things considered. That could have gone really poorly. But careful use of cooldowns kind of carried us through it. All right. So let's cut our way through this. Yeah, our damage is pretty good right now. I'm pretty pleased with it. All right. I was gonna say, of these, the most irritating thing is going to be that damn wizard up there. Ah, we didn't bleed that guy. That's disappointing. I'm gonna kill that wizard. All right, he's bleeding. So, all right. I was gonna say, he's gonna probably die anyways, but we punched that shinobi and it threw our weapon at him. So,
yeah.
All right. Let's see here. We have a bleed on us, which is dangerous. I'm gonna activate fervor. Punch you. How do I want to handle this? Actually, I know how I'm going to handle this. I'm going to kind of approach. Oh my god. Whatever. I'm just going to start yelling and fire is going to happen. And it's going to suck for these dudes. Ow. Good hit. Rip your wit. Oh, that's the boss. I did not even notice that. In that case, we're going to back off for a second here. I think we could kill both of these things without doing this, and I'd be okay, but I'm gonna drink a healing potion. Evade this. You're dead. Yeah. That was not wanna leave. We have goodies to obtain. Do not leave. Okay. There we go. I think we've probably cleared the place. Yeah, we bumped into the leader a little earlier than I was expecting. I was expecting him to be a little further back. That's okay. I'm not particularly pained. All right. That went smoothly enough. We're gonna go ahead and rest here before we go to the overworld. All right. I'm gonna continue adventuring a little bit. Oh, it's mundane here for whatever reason, but as soon as we move this way, it's like, hey, we're back to adventurous. So I entered this fight so that I could show you guys that depending on the terrain, these random encounters are different. You've noticed that kind of like forests are forested and stuff. This is a mountainous one. We are not going to be fighting this. I just wanted to show it off. And there's, I think, one other type. I think the grass plains ones are very similar to forests. And then there's, like I said, there's, I think, another one that we aren't going to bump into until later into the game. Okay. Continue. Like, the lack of dungeons is kind of worrying me. Because I need something to explore, but it's looking like they're going to force me into dangerous terrain to do it. So, this is a thing. Road ambush. Alright, see, that's an archer to the right. I'm gonna come down this way. I trust my hand more so with these dudes than with all this other stuff. Alright, that was actually really helpful. Thank you for that. Then activate our defensive cooldowns. And deep roll the thunder, these guys. Okay. Weapon bending, and we're gonna take you out. And now we're gonna take, oh, it's too expensive. Get some fire going. There we go, good spread on it. Now we just start doing what we do, which is to say punching everything to death. Hangling, I swear. All right, down here. I have no idea what just hit me there. Oh, the bee halberdier. He actually charged at me, but he hit the rock. That's pretty funny. Oh, let's get some fire out. Get some more fire out. Good job, frog. You tried. All right, there we go. A blood glue brew, which will stop bleeding on you. Which later in the game is incredibly handy, although we have our primary ability, which I believe stops bleeding on us, which is something I need to remember because bleeding gets really, really lethal later in the game. I see, we have a dangerous roadblock. This might be, is this a mountain roadblock or is this, nope, just a standard road. All right, this one, since it's dangerous, I'm actually very tempted to just go around and see if I can just pull the boss because this is gonna be nasty, I think, depending. I love it. That archer's just so mad. Where's the boss? Is that him right up there in the center? Okay, good job, mage. Thanks for throwing your allies at me. Oh no, he's right behind that tree to my north. Okay, let's go ahead and drink a barkskin potion. Let's activate Rapier Wit. We're gonna counterattack him really nasty, like, only 32, that's disappointing. That was a little better. Not bad, but you lose. Not bad at all. Nice drops, okay. Oh, I think he dropped a map, actually. Yeah, I think that's a map there, interesting. All right, so we're not gonna be able to hit that guy, alas, from here. Here, I think I should be able to from. Ah! Trees don't count as walls. Trees should count as walls for jumping. All right, I'm not gonna chase you. You get weapon bending. Get out of here. All right, I'm just gonna rest because they're, all right, I'm just gonna sit here because they're not gonna come for me. That's the thing is like, if you rest, it gets rid of all of your ire from Southern Gentlemen's, but if you just sit there and pass turns, which is the same as resting, it doesn't, so I don't know. So was that a map? Yeah, that's a map. All right, threat level's 8. So I mean, we're not gonna be able to do it, but we have it. It's a dungeon filled with slimes and jiggling jellies, along with fanatical cultists, which means that we're probably not gonna be able to do this. That having been said, we did get a map. That's cool, those are rare drops. I think they have like a 1 in 10 chance to drop from bosses like that. That was the last I heard him talking about it. I think that's what the dev said it was. But that, again, may have changed. I know I talk a lot about stuff the devs said because I tend to lurk on his programming streams to kind of watch what he's doing. It's fascinating. So I know, for example, that in the next update that he pushes out, which is probably going to come with the Pay to Lose DLC on Friday, I know he's implementing throwing the door spikes because I watched him implement it. But, you know, don't take anything I'm saying here as, you know, gospel or anything, because everything is liable to change. Nothing is set in stone. Like, features and stuff that I've seen him implement, you can probably rely on those. But details, you know, there's no guarantee there. All right, so this is mundane, so I think, like, if I just proc my defensive stuff here, we should be able to just run in here and punch our way to victory. I'm not really too worried, yeah. These guys are pretty helpless. They tried. They tried. Well, I'm coming for you. Don't think I'm... Actually, you know what? No. We're gonna let them live. Another map. Nice. We're gonna let them live. Part of me wonders if maybe maps shouldn't drop on content that's this low level. Because, I mean, we're 3 levels away from being able to even run maps. But I'm kind of thankful for it because by the time we get to the point that we will be able to run them, hey, we'll have a couple maps. This one is... Murderers and Crafty Bees, of course. Additional ranged strikers with poison and bleeding attacks. That's just horrible. I want none of that. We did, however, get some better armor, some substantially better armor. Holy crap. We're gonna wear that. Let's see, do I have bolster armor? Do I have fortify? No. Well, we'll bolster this. Death Steel Shine chest guard. Alright. A fluid deft steel shine chest guard. Super fluid deft steel shine chest guard. So we've got parry dodge dodge. Nice. That's actually pretty good because we're kind of dodging is our thing, even though we're running around in heavy armor. And so now we have a 30% chance to dodge attacks. And when we take a hit, it reduces damage by almost 60%. So like we have some pretty good survivability here. That is very, very pleasing. I'm not too interested in those pants. Did I clear this? I don't remember if I cleared this. Did I sneak around here? Or did this come from elsewhere? Oh my god, dude. Like, if you're gonna be a dick about it, fine. Can't tell. Nope, he's still over there, alright. Nope. Alright. Hey, buddy. Hey, that's right. Come get some. Will he reach me? Oh, I've run out of stamina. He may. And then he immediately dies. He tried, though. A for effort. A for effort. You know, he's got good hustle. Alright. He's got good hustle for a corpse. Ha ha! Alright. Yeah, I mean, like, there's no dungeons. The game is like just, yeah, you don't get anything good. It's horrible. There a dungeon over here, maybe? game? No, it's just that. Okay, there we go. We have a mundane and a mundane. So we have two mundane dungeons. Oh my lord. I'm gonna see, we're gonna avoid this. I'm going to get us back to the academy. We'll turn stuff in and then we're gonna call this because we are half an hour. Oh, we got ambushed by some bees. Oh, but they're not very close. All right, this should be over quickly. I'm just gonna run to the left. Let's see, what is this potion? Depending on what this is, heartburn, that is a bad potion. I believe you drink those and they light you on fire. I think I have some of them, actually. Heartburn, yeah. Burn with terrible heat, taking constant damage and dealing fire damage with melee attacks. All right, there we go. So, I mean, maybe that's our light ourselves on fire option right there before, you know, fighting an enemy. All right, so let's see kind of what kind of goodies we have here. I'm curious. See if anything's worth anything. Hey there. I brought relics. Proofs of strength. And a relic. Let's see. Overflowing. I don't think we have any books. No. I'm curious what we have to do. I'm really curious what we have to do to get the map room. Because, like, we're finding maps now, so I'm wondering what we have to do. Unless we have to, like, beat a map boss or something, which I suppose would be sensible. Hey there, buddy. I want you to melt down all of my gear that can't be psychotossed. There we go. So now, basically, you won't psychotoss, I believe, magical items. It's only trash loot that you'll psychotoss. So you can see that I still have my, like, armor here for when I want to start building the towers and whatnot. Spend our proofs. We got 8 of them. I'll go with 1 strength, and I'm tempted to shore up skills some more. Even though it's mostly ranged. Increases the potency of your potions and scrolls and the durations of my curses, bleeds, poisons, and other lasting effects. 15 science adds 3.75. How much is it? It doesn't tell you until you've spent points into it. Here, let's bump it up to 16 and see what this is. 4.5, all right, so it's 0.75 resistance per point, which, I mean, that's not bad. I'm mostly interested in the bleeds, the increased duration. I don't know how many you need to have a reasonable increase to your duration, but that might be a thing. I'm gonna, I think, just hold on to these 3 proofs that we're running right now, and I'm gonna call it. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I will see you all next time, where the adventure continues. Until then.